And I'm sure that you already have read my introduction to Arabic that I sent it today. So this is called formal Arabic or standard Arabic. It is also known in the Arabic language as Fusha. Fusha, right? Probably you have heard. Fusha is against the colloquial or the slang. Every language, one is a standard, one is a slang, right? Slang is the language that the people, they speak on the street, native people. So they have so many words, their pronunciation is different from the Fusha. But this is Fusha is the lingua franca among the leaders of Arab people. There are more than 50 Arabic countries and they speak differently, their dialects are different. But when they summit in a conference, in a big, you know, summit over there, they use only one language. And this is standard Arabic. So their speeches are in this one. All the Arabic newspapers, you pick any newspaper, no matter it is printed in Sudan or in Misr or in Jordan or in Iraq or Saudi Arabia, all the language of all the newspaper is same. And this is this one. So, and if you watch the channels, Arabic channels, for example, Al Jazeera channel or any other Arabic channel, so when you see the news, at that time the news reader, they will be speaking this Arabic, standard Arabic, not their own dialect or the colloquial. So that's why this was the desire of so many of our brothers and sisters that we should learn this one also. So in addition to learning the classical Arabic, we should know this modern Arabic, standard Arabic also. And it was developed more in 19th century and towards the end of 18th century. But this Arabic also has a root in the classical Arabic. So you will, when you will learn, you will read, you will find out that both of them, they do not have that much difference. And the common thing is that the grammar of the Arabic is same. Grammar for this Arabic or that Arabic is same, it's common. So once you are learning one thing, as a matter of fact, I was reading the first lesson of both books, and I found out that both of them, they are complementing each other. Mm-hmm. Complementing each other. So it's a very good thing and the easiest part for you. Now, you need to buy this book also, and it is available on so many websites. First of all, Amazon.com, you can find it. It was given. If you want to buy, just want to go physically, so if you go to UTD, there are two bookstores. One is on Campbell Road, that is known as off-site campus bookstore. If you go there, you can buy from there also. Okay. Just tell them that you need this book. If you cannot memorize the whole name, let me make it easy for you. Tell that, you know, assume that you are the student at UTD, you are a university student. Say that I need the book for the class. It's not working well. Let me use red this book. Arab. 1312.
Okay.
This is easy, right? Mm-hmm. This is the course name, Arab 1312. If you just tell them that I need the book for this course, they will give you the same book. So you can buy from there. One bookstore is inside the campus. That is called University Bookstore. And that is located in the main building of Visitor Center. If you go as a visitor, so everyone has to go to that building first, because they give you the parking permit and everything. And the same building you have the bookstore. So you can just buy from there. So I told you two physical addresses for the book, and you can go online. This book also has a website that is known Al-Kitab. A-L-K-I-T-A-A-B. Al-Kitab.com. Mm. That is another website that you can buy the book.
Yeah, you see the picture of the people in the market. Trying to buy something.
Yeah. Okay. Anyway, we will spend 30 minutes every class for this book or for this standard Arabic. Then remaining 20 minutes we will be using for the spoken Arabic. Okay? Again, coming back to the slang or colloquial. And why there is a need for that? The need is that no matter how many years you spend for learning Arabic, you are very good, mashallah, in Quranic Arabic, in classic Arabic. You are very good in this Arabic. But if you would like to communicate with a common folks of any Arab person, the way he is speaking to you, you cannot understand what he or she is saying. And you cannot be understood if you started talking to him in this language, it will be very hard for him to understand. He will think you are reading the Quran. In order to communicate with native Arab people, you need to learn this colloquial Arabic. Okay? We are going to use this very best program that is developed by Dr. Pimsleur. Dr. Pimsleur, he was a professor. He spent all his life for teaching different languages. So he developed this program and he is claiming that I have made at the same way, very natural way, like a child who started speaking his or her own native language. So the way the children, they learn their own language, you will learn Arabic in that way. That is his claim. So we will spend 20 minutes. Mm-hmm. Now for this one, you can write down the website of this Pimsleur with his name, just Pimsleur. Just go pimsleur.com and you will see the CD set. The very first CD set they will send you, it has 8 CDs. And 8 CDs have 16 lessons. Every CD has 2 lessons. Okay? And as advertisement, they made it very cheap, very nominal, just $9.99, like $10. In $10, you can get all 8 CDs, all 16 lessons. Okay, but when they see that now you are interested more, then they will go up and then they will send the whole like a binder with I don't remember, but it has a very good number of the CDs, and I have in my office, so I will bring next time. I will show you what is the next one they will send. But for a while, only these 8 CDs will be enough, because it will take a lot of time for us to be master. So for $10, you will be okay for several months, inshallah. Okay? So you can write down this one. Now, he has developed in different dialects. This is one that I am showing you. It's an Egyptian dialect. We are not going to buy Egyptian. Okay? We are going to buy Eastern Arabic. Write down Eastern. And it's written over here in this one, Eastern Arabic. Yeah. So just you can write down Eastern Arabic. Okay. So Eastern Arabic includes the area of Syria. It is also known Syrian dialect. These are two prominent dialects, Egyptian and Syrian, throughout the Arab world. Egyptian used to be dominating because all the media was there. So Egypt also, when it comes to making the movies, TV programs, so like we have Hollywood in America, so Hollywood of Arab countries was Misr or Egypt. So that's why this Egypt was dominating throughout the Arab, but not anymore. Now Syrian dialect is dominating. And when we talk about Syrian dialect, it includes Beirut, Lebanon, Palestine, and Israel, that area. Then Jordan, all the eastern part of Arabic world, they all be using this dialect. So inshallah, it will be very much helpful for you. And when you speaking the same language of the Arab people, when you will be communicating with them, you will feel some kind of accomplishment. You will be having a confidence. Oh, I can speak now, right? I can talk to Arab people in their language. So that's why we will be using 20 minutes, inshallah, for this, our goal. So we have then three objectives. Brother Hassan, can you repeat all these three objectives?
Oh,
yes, sure.
Just woke me up.
Yeah. I put you on the spot.
Well, the first objective is the Quranic, classical Quranic classes.
Yes.
And that is going to be regarding this, at the same time learning the Quranic language.
So what is the benefit of that?
Because we would understand, we would get familiar with the phrases and the surahs.
Yeah.
And would understand the meaning, hopefully, the meaning of the word.
Yes.
And the second one would be
Fusha.
The Fusha.
Yes.
Fusha Arabic, that is the written Arabic, right?
The
modern standard
for the language of the newspapers, TV channels, for the news especially.
And the third part would be the conversation.
Conversational Arabic, very good. Yes. And we are going to use Syrian dialect. So everyone is ready, inshallah?
Inshallah.
You have last minute to walk out. Okay, very good. So, I also would like to introduce in this class our guest. Okay, he's our dear brother, Mr. Greg. He will be joining also this class. And Mr. Greg, he lived for several years in Middle Eastern countries. So lately he spent 1.5 years in Qatar and some other countries.
Lebanon.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So he was also most of the time in the eastern side of our world, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we welcome you, Greg, over here.
Thank you.
And inshallah. Okay. So this is our first book. Yes.
Is it possible to get a copy of your lectures that you deliver?
Yes. I already
prepared
the information.
Sorry.
No problem. They are all available now on the Masjid website.
Yeah. I've been through your last lectures, and in that you were reading, you were teaching from the book Alif Ba. And you also were teaching the Masri dialect.
Yes.
As against the Syrian dialect.
Yes.
Is there a very good reason that we're changing to these books?
Yeah, I just, actually that book, Alif Ba, was for the beginners Arabic, that level. That was beginning part one. Does anyone have that?
I have it.
Okay.
So same teacher, right?
Actually. So that's why he was covering both dialects.
Okay. Yes. And now this time we are using this book as a part two and the Syrian dialect. And we will stick on the Syrian dialect from now and on.
Okay.
Inshallah. So, our very first lesson, okay, now how many people you have this book? None over here? Okay. How many to the brother side? Just one? You have one? You can also order on Darussalam. What do you mean by another? This is the only one course by Abdul Rahman.
Example like this.
Oh, that
this
one?
Is also by the same author, Abdul Rahman.
I'll see it later on.
Probably change over
from the small ones. Hopefully, the one with Darussalam is out of stock everywhere.
Oh, really?
And then, obviously, the same book, previous editions are all available. So I didn't buy because you were mentioning in the last class they buy this one. But this one is out of stock everywhere. It's very hard to find.
This one? Yeah. I bought mine online, but it's like 3 months ago.
I did not see the other one, probably I will see it later.
Okay, but you now, you know, internet is a very easy access, so you need to look at this book through different websites. Whenever you, maybe Barnes and Noble, they also, you know, sell it, okay? Then Amazon.com, and just write the name of the book, and inshallah you should be able to get it from any source. But it should not be any excuse not having the book. And some brother Kanishka, did you tell me that you ordered on October 1st?
This one. Yeah.
And
from
it came just in 3 days.
Yeah, from Barnes and Noble.
We got it on October 4th. Yes. Okay. For this one,
on textbook.com is half price.
Okay.
So if somebody wants to save money, order through textbook.
Can you come and write down the website address?
It's textbook.com.
Textbook.com. Okay, please write down one address, textbook.com. But that address is for this book. He says that it is available at half price. Okay, so
I think he emailed
it out. And I also learned a lesson, but probably next time we should order the books, and we should keep the books
yes,
for everyone over here. I thought it's a free country, I should give the freedom to everyone, right?
Especially this book is so popular that so many editions are available. Like the author is very popular, it looks like, so because at least 10 different versions are available.
Yes. I know I taught the old, you know, edition also, old, but I didn't like it after seeing this one. It has some more information, and this, you know, the paper, the quality of printing. It also, they added the pictures. The previous edition, they did not have any picture. For example, if you go on page number 1, so it has all the pictures of Hada Miftah, Hada Kitab, Hada Qalam, Hada Masjid, Hada Bayt. There was no picture at all in the old edition. So please do not buy that one or do not bring that one. Okay? Okay, so just one book and...
I have the book, it has the same things.
Okay.
I have the same similar one too.
Okay, very good then. This is good. Then you can share.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's the one. It's the same thing.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You have also the same one?
Yeah, this one.
So please give one book to the sister side. Give that one. And if the sisters come close, inshallah, and just look so that we can start very first lesson. Okay, let me tell you the procedure how to read this book. It has two sides. One side is Arabic, one side is English. So if you open the book from left side, that is the English way, then you will find the first lesson in English. So all the introduction of the lesson, the content of the lesson, and the explanation, everything is given in English to the left side. For example, this says lesson number 1, right? Now, when you go to this side, that is the right side of the book, everything you will find in Arabic. So if you open the book from the right side, so everything you see in Arabic. Okay? And both of them, English and Arabic, they are corresponding to each other. The same thing that whatever is written over here in lesson number 1 in English, the examples and the explanation of that was given in Arabic. Okay? So it's not the case that lesson number 1 in English is different and lesson number 1 in Arabic, or you say Ad-Darsul Awwal, lesson 1 in Arabic, Ad-Darsul Awwal is different. No, it's the same thing. So they will explain the content, the topic in English first, because it's meant for English speaking people. They will introduce, for example, the very first topic about the demonstrative pronoun, that is called or known Hada, Hada in Arabic, right? This is the very first thing that they are introducing. Hada means this. So it could be this pen, this book, right? This bottle, this masjid, this building, this man, this woman. You need to use this a lot, right? It's called demonstrative pronoun. So, they introduce in the first lesson, number 1. So, they are also saying in this lesson, we learn the following things. The very first thing that maybe the, you know, the kids, they ask, they have so many questions. They ask their mom and dad, what is this, right? What is this? This is a natural question. It comes from the children. So he also brought the very first Mahada. Mahada. So if you wanna ask someone in Arabic, what is this? You say Mahada. So repeat after me. Mahada. Mahada. What do you think, sisters, or only one sister, raise your hand, what the meaning of what? What is the word for what in Arabic, in this? Ma, right? So ma means what. And now it is clear that the meaning of this, they come from the word hada. Ma hada, right. Now, the second step that you need to learn about Arabic since the very first day, that Arabic very sensitive language in terms of the gender. We have different words for the male, masculine gender. We have different word for feminine gender. So if the thing that you are asking the question, Mahada, you will say Hada if the thing is masculine gender. And this masculine gender not only being used for the human beings, but for everything. For the animals, for even non-living things. This kitab also is a masculine gender in Arabic. So if you are pointing to the book, you will say Mahada. As compared to the feminine genders, there are so many things that they are being used in Arabic as feminine. So not only the women or the girls, but there are so many animals. Again, non-living things. For example, non-living things, your car. What is the word for car in Arabic?
Sayyara.
So Sayyara is a feminine gender. Okay? So if you ask pointing to the car, what is this? Then you say Mahadihi. Mahadihi. I will write both of them. So you can make a comparison between masculine and feminine. Now pay attention to the ending of both words. I will make a line, I will make underline this part. Whatever part is underlined with the green line, it's a common in between both of them, right? Up to there. The difference is over here, the last ending. For male is ending on alif, a sound, and for female is ending is he sound, he, right? So this is the difference. And you are going to see this here a lot, ending for feminine gender. As a matter of fact, when you say sayyara, that is your car. So this ending, this letter is called ta marbuta. Ta marbuta. Ta is the letter ta. Marbuta means rounded. Because the shape of this ta is rounded. We have another shape of ta.
Two dots.
That is, you write this one, right? And you know this. So this is called ta tawila, long. Flat shape. This one is called ta marbuta, rounded. So there are many Arabic words, they are ending on this rounded ta. This is a feminine marker also. Whenever you see this one, most of the cases, it's an indication that this word is feminine gender in Arabic. Okay? However, there are some exceptions, and we will, you know, go to those exceptions also. For example, there are names, male names. For example, the name Talha, the male name Talha, it is ending on the ta marbuta, but it's not feminine. Yeah, so these are some exceptions. Okay. So they introduce with this word, Mahada. The second thing I will tell about this discussion, and then we will stop over here, because we are now going over the time for this part, right? Mm-hmm. The writing of this word, hada. We are saying ha, hada. Like, this should be the spelling, right? Ha and alif, right? Ha. We do not say hada. Without alif is hada. So we are not saying it, right? But we are reading it hada. So what happened over there? Actually, there was another alif, you know, shape of alif that is known as dagger alif. In English, we say dagger alif. It looks like dagger. Or in Arabic, it's called alif khanjari, khanjar or dagger. So when the teachers, they teach the kids, they call it also short alif. Short alif. So you just, you know, take it as a short alif. This alif that you know is the regular alif, it has different shapes. Same pronunciation, but different shape. So this alif is another version or another shape of this alif. Both of them. Okay? Mm-hmm. Like one is elder brother, one is younger brother. Mm-hmm. Right? But both of them are equal in the pronunciation. When they pronounce, you need to pronounce same way. No difference in the pronunciation. And do you know the natural length of alif? How should we stretch it? Someone answer?
Two seconds.
Or if you raise your finger, you should be able to raise it two times. Okay? For example, if you are saying the word kitab. So the word kitab has alif after ta. So kitab. Right? So this is the natural length of the pronunciation. So this alif or that alif, both are same. So this word used to be written with this alif. But what happened with a lot of, use of this writing style, Arab people, they stopped writing this shape of alif. Okay? They are not writing it, but still they are pronouncing it. So whenever you see this word without alif, you need to believe, you need to assume that alif is there. Though it is not visible, but it is there. So we will always read with alif. So if you see it without alif, do not make mistake in reading. Don't say mahada. It will be hada. Hada. Okay. And then the whole discussion in this book was given for using this hada in the first page. When you go to the Arabic portion, there are so many words, they have been introduced with hada. So this is your vocabulary also. From this page you will see so many words. The first one is hada bayt, and the picture of the house. So bayt means house. The second, hada masjid. So hada is repeating for every word. Then the third one is hada bab. Bab means door. The fourth is hada kitab. Kitab is book. Fifth, hada qalam. Qalam is pen. Any pen. Then sixth, hada miftah. Miftah is your keys. Everyone has the keys, right? All these keys. So you need to use a lot. Then the seventh one is hada maktab. Now maktab has two meanings. One is your desk where you are writing. The second meaning is your office. When you go to office, that is your maktab. Okay. Next one is hada sarir. Sarir is the most favorite things of every one of us. This is our bed. Night time we take our complete, you know, sleep. So your bed, in your bedroom, that is sarir. The next one is kursi. Kursi is the chair that you all are sitting on, the chair, except me. So this is kursi. So in just one page, you learned 9 words, right? Another very golden rule about the vocabulary is that whenever you learn the word, just do not learn for sake of learning or reading. You need to activate those words. Meaning you are going to use in your daily life. Then you relate those words with your daily life. If you are not using them, then there is no benefit of learning. No benefit of learning. I always give the example. This is the example of the activation of your cell phone. If you buy a nice iPhone, a smartphone, and you just bring it to your home and you leave it over there without the activation, what is the benefit of this phone, right? Whatever $100 you spend is not going to mean anything. But when you are activated, now you are using it. So every word that you learn in Arabic, activate it. And you are the owner of this word now. You are the owner, you own these words. So take the vocabulary, new vocabulary in that way. So inshallah, when you will get the book, so you will, as soon as before the second class, try to learn these all words, use them, make your own short sentences, whatever you can make. And one more thing, when you are making sentences, do not worry at all about the mistakes. In the beginning, you will do a lot of mistakes, right? So the more mistakes you will do, the more easily you will learn.